Hello and welcome to Meridia. My name is Ahmed Jamil Malik. I am a Meridia intern and a fourth year medical student in Sheikh Zayed Medical College, Lahore. We, the interns of Meridia, have begun our series on biostatistics. And for that, the topic of today's presentation will be case control study. Before beginning my discussion on case control study, I would like to thank my mentors, Dr. Khwaja and Dr. Tariq, for helping me in the compilation of this video. So the case control study. A case control study is basically a retrospective study, which means we are looking backwards in time. In this study, we have two groups with different but known outcomes, and we are going to compare the two groups based on a supposed risk factor. The two groups being the cases and the controls. So the subjects who have the condition or the disease will be termed as the cases. They will be compared with those subjects who don't have the condition or the disease. So we will be comparing the cases with the controls. And in this study, we will be basically answering questions like what happened that led to the development of the disease. So before moving forwards, we need to define the risk factor. The risk factor is basically something that happened before the occurrence of the disease, and it has increased the chances of disease development. Now let's imagine a scenario. Let's say we have a population of cancer patients in the oncology ward of Mayo Hospital. And we have diverse population of cancer patients, since we have thyroid cancer patients, prostate cancer patients, breast cancer patients. So from this population, we take a small sample of only those subjects who have been diagnosed with skin cancer and those who have not been diagnosed and they don't have skin cancer. So we divide them into two groups, those who have the skin cancer as the cases and those who don't have the skin cancer as the controls. Now we want to find out whether excessive exposure to sunlight had any role in the development of cancer in these patients. So based on this history questionnaire, we can divide our groups into two further subgroups. The cases, how many of them were exposed with the risk factor, which is sunlight, and how many of the skin cancer patients were not exposed with the sunlight and they developed the cancer. Similarly, the controls, how many of them were exposed with the risk factor and how many of them have not been exposed with the risk factor. So based on this study, we will be able to find out the relationship between ultraviolet radiation of sunlight and the development of skin cancer. So the design of a case control study. A case control study begins with the cases, those who have the condition, and we compare them with the controls, those who don't have the condition. And based on a history questionnaire, we divide them into two further subgroups. The cases, how many of them have been exposed with a risk factor, and how many of the cases have not been exposed with the risk factor and remained unexposed. Similarly, how many of the controls, those who don't have the condition, have been exposed with the risk factor and they did not develop the condition. And how many of the controls have not been exposed with the risk factor and remained unexposed. In order to simplify this, let's take an example. Let's say we have oral cancer patients and we want to find out whether chewing of tobacco had any role in the development of cancer in these patients. So we will take those who have oral cancers and have been properly diagnosed as the cases and those who don't have oral cancer as the controls. And we will divide them into two further subgroups based on a questionnaire or history. And how many of the oral cancer patients have history of chewing of tobacco? And how many of the oral cancer patients don't have history of chewing of tobacco? Similarly, the controls without the oral cancer, how many of them used to chew tobacco and they did not develop oral cancer? And how many of the controls did not chew any tobacco and they haven't developed any oral cancer? So regarding the selection of the cases, there is a proper criteria. For example, for the cancer patients, it can be a certain histological findings in their biopsy. It can be the date of diagnosis of their cancer. It can be cancer patients from a certain geographical location where cancer is very prevalent. And regarding their selection, it is seen that the newer cases are preferred to those to the older ones. And similarly, regarding the selection of the controls, we choose controls from the same population from which we are choosing the cases. And when we are choosing the controls, it is better to choose controls from the same hospital or the same institution as that of the cases. Another example of a case control study is adenocarcinoma of the vagina with diethylstilbestrol. Diethylstilbestrol in the past was used to prevent miscarriage, but later on it was found to be teratogenic, so its use was stopped. So in order to find the association between adenocarcinoma of the vagina with diethylstilbestrol, a case control study was conducted. So in this study, risk factors related to diethylstilbestrol were studied in 156 patients whose mother had documented use of diethylstilbestrol. And for the controls, 1848 other women who had diethylstilbestrol exposure but they did not develop any cancer were interviewed. relative risks were higher for those children whose mother had documented use of diethylstilbestrol before the 12th week of pregnancy. Similarly, the risks were higher in those individuals whose mother had history of at least one spontaneous abortion. So via using this study, we were able to find out that the association between the adenocarcinoma of the vagina with documented use of diethylstilbestrol. So what are the advantages and disadvantages of a case-controlled study? The main advantage is that it can be used to study rare diseases, for example mesothelioma, and it requires comparatively fewer subjects compared to a cohort. And there is no risk development to the subjects, and it is rapid and inexpensive. The disadvantage is that we cannot distinguish between the main cause factor or the associated factor of another cause. And since we are looking at the past, we cannot measure the incidence, and we are relying on the memory of the people to recall their past, so there is a chance of recall bias. So multifactorial case control study. So far we have seen that we studied only one factor related to a disease in our study. However, it is possible to investigate multiple exposure factors in the same study. So for that, let's take an example. A study was done where mothers of leukemic children were interviewed while the age of the children were just 1 to 4 years old. So for the controls, another 13,000 women with the same history were interviewed. So four factors were considered for this study, two being preconceptional factors and two being postconceptional factors. The preconceptional factors included preconceptional radiation or history of any previous reproductive wastes. And the postconceptional factors were in utero radiation history, or during the pregnancy if there was exposure of uterus to radiation, or there was any history or development of viral infection during the pregnancy. So later on it was found that all of these factors were somehow contributing to the development of leukemia in children. So using only one study, we can find multiple factors related to a disease. So that is pretty much up for this video. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. And like we always say, never give up, never lose hope. Take care.